हेलो एंड वेलकम टू प्रैक्टिकल प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 12 ऑफ सब्जेक्ट अप्लाइड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। माय सेल्फ संजीत कुमार सिंह, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट एट प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भेंदर। इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी आर इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द क्लास ए पावर एम्पलीफायर। हियर इज द सर्किट डायग्राम विद द वैल्यूज। व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स रिक्वायर्ड टू परफॉर्म दिस प्रैक्टिकल? हियर वी हैव द table of it. So the transistor used for our practical is BC558. We can use the other transistor BD115 or SL or CL100 as well. The VCC can be provided 12 volt, and the coupling capacitors we have used on the input side 47 microfarad, and the emitter bypass capacitor is of 10 microfarad. The potential divider resistor R1 and R2 are 47 kilo ohm and 33 ohm, and the load resistor here or RC is 220 ohm and RE is 560 ohm. VCC we have provided 2 volt and is working properly. So before we perform the practical, we must understand what are the competency required. So first and foremost, it is to use discrete electronic devices and voltage regulators by performing this practical. And the other relevant course outcome is to use BJT as high power amplifier, and practical outcome is to build or test performance parameters of single stage class A power amplifier. So we have already covered the theoretical part of it. So class A is the simplest of transistor amplifier, power amplifier, in which the IC current is flowing for complete 360 degree for positive as well as in negative half cycle of the input AC signal. Output current IC will flow. So that continuous current flow through the RC will provide a loss for the amplifier, and hence the efficiency will be from 25 to 50 maximum. Theoretical efficiency that can be obtained is 50%. So here what we see, this is the input signal, sinusoidal input signal that is fed to the base of the transistor, and the transistor is amplifying and giving 180 degree phase shifted. With single stage we have 180 degree phase shifted output and amplified output obtained from the collector with respect to the ground. For the observation table, here we have the observation table. We record the input voltage V in, that of the AC signal, the output voltage V out, that is amplified AC signal in the second column. PAC is V output square by twice RL. RL here we have 200 ohm, that is the nothing but the RC value, and VCC we have taken 2 volt. So by substituting the values of 230 millivolt square by twice into 200, we get this AC power as 120.120 milliwatt. And similarly PDC is VCC into ICQ. So here we require the ICQ. So to find the ICQ, what we do, we take the current reading through the resistor RC by inserting 1 ohm, 1 ammeter here, that will measure the current without giving the AC input. So we are neglecting this part. Without giving this AC input, what is the current due to this VCC is the ICQ. So that we are noting, and we have noted here for the first reading 0.58 milliampere. With the help of the digital multimeter, we can measure from our circuit, we can measure the IC current. Here this is LO wire, can be replaced with an ammeter to measure the IC current. This is the RC, this is R1, R2, this is the input coupling capacitor, and here we have the RE and the CE bypass capacitor. These two wires are for the input, giving input AC signal to be amplified. This is applied at the base of the transistor, and output is taken from the collector. So this is the collector point, and from here itself we are taking the output with respect to common emitter on the second channel. So we are calculating the VCC into ICQ. If VCC given is 2 multiplied with the ICQ measured, we are getting 1.16 milliwatt DC power, that is the input power. And efficiency is calculated as the output power, AC output power, by the DC input power multiplied with 100, since we are expressing in terms of percentage. So we are getting for the first reading 10.31%, then for the second reading we are getting 36.12%, and third reading we are getting 21.57. Here is sample calculation for the second reading. We are calculating the PAC, PDC, and finally the efficiency of the class A power amplifier. So we find that the efficiency we are getting from 36 here maximum. So that 36 is the maximum efficiency we are obtaining in this practical at for input of 200 millivolt, and the frequency of the input is AC input is 200 hertz. So now we'll see the terminals of the transistor. Here we can see for BC558, first one is the collector, then second base and emitter. So collector, here we have the lower one is the collector, first left hand side flat portion is held in front with the help of our left hand. So first terminal on the left will be collector, then base, then emitter. Third terminal is emitter. So this is the practical setup. We have given 2 volt VCC, and here is the output. First channel is the input, that is near about 200 hertz input, and peak to peak we see here 1.2 into 1.1 means 100 millivolt. So that is near about 210 millivolt input, and output we are getting 1, 2, 3 divisions means 100 into 3. The knob, second knob, output knob is at 0.1, that means 100 millivolt per division. So 300 millivolt we are getting. So similarly we are changing the input, that is the AC input, and noting the output. So here we see less amplification of the input signal. This is at 20 hertz, very small input.